give me a little bit of history about her. Tell me about her story.
So Athenis is from Puerto Rico.
Okay.
From what we understand, she's been living on her own.
Okay.
Rescuers tried to catch her for quite a few months.
Okay.
She was living when they caught her under tractor trailers. So like an abandoned tractor trailer yard in Puerto Rico.
Okay.
What we know and from what records we have, she has anaplasmosis.
Okay.
She does have some sort of a lung condition. We still don't know if she has pneumonia, and she also has possible heart condition. That's why they reached out to us to get her here, because she wasn't getting the right care there, or the right care wasn't available for her there.
Okay.
But so we don't really have very conclusive what exactly is wrong with her.
So the anaplasma to me is almost kind of like a marker that we have strong exposure to these tick-borne infections, and certainly living on the streets, you know, there's no doubt that she's been exposed to a lot. So I would like to test her for some other common tick-borne diseases like Ehrlichia, other things like Babesia is a disease of the red blood cells that can actually affect pitties in particular.
Really?
So that would be something that I'd want to test her
and
for.
And that would also give that blood count?
It could, yeah, because her red blood cell count was pretty low, and her platelet count also was low, so we can definitely see both of those things.
Okay.
So I think we need to look a little bit further. I did want to do full blood work on her today, too,
right. Yeah,
in
sure,
addition to that infectious disease testing. The other things, so in addition to chest rads, because her appetite seems like it's kind of all over the place, and with her infectious disease exposure, I think doing an ultrasound, too, would be a good idea while she's here. I know it's like a lot of things were thrown at you, but
no,
I feel like
I mean, we're here for a reason.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when we have a case that's, you know,
what do you think?
Complex.
Yeah.
I don't like wasting time and
figure
it out.
I'm glad you guys came.
She's very special. She's absolutely worthy of getting help and the right treatment too.
Okay, so Dr. Palermo at UPenn is taking Athenis into getting some lab work done, some diagnostics. Chest x-ray, I'm going to call in the cardiologist to see what's going on, and also to do a special screening for some infectious diseases a little bit deeper than the typical screening. While Athenis is getting looked at, we're going to go grab something to eat and be back. There's a possibility that she may have to stay overnight, so we'll see in a couple of hours from Dr. Palermo.
Okay, so we're at JFK Airport right now, and we're about to go inside to pick up Nala. Nala was found in the streets of Puerto Rico with no mobility in her back legs, and she was covered in ants, which were actually eating her alive. So she was rescued, and then she's been down there for about a year and a half, as I understand, in a shelter, not really receiving the medical attention that she needs. So we're gonna go right now, we're gonna scoop her up, we're gonna put her in the truck, and we're gonna drive her out to East End, and we're gonna get her the medical attention that she needs. We're gonna evaluate her, and we're gonna see exactly what we could do for her to see if that is, she might be able to walk again. So come with us.
Come on, okay.
Let's go. Let's go right here.
sores on her pelvic bones. You have to watch them closely. So because she has a staph infection, she has some urine scalding and a pressure sore, and she's just generally grungy. We gave her a bath today with Cuticlor shampoo and Malicep shampoo to help handle bacteria infections as well as yeast overgrowth. And now we are going to apply a long-lasting leave-on conditioner, which will condition the coat and also help prevent the buildup of yeast and bacteria going forward. And we're hoping that with good nutrition and continuous bathing, we can resolve this. She does need some antibiotics for the urine scald and pressure sore area on her left flank, but we're hoping that we can prevent that from getting any worse. And once we get her fitted into her wheelchair, actually prevent that from happening anymore. So that's it. And we'll do some laser therapy on her spine, and we'll do some laser therapy on that hip to help promote healing.
Yeah, this is the Bully Crew calling. I'm calling about the dog.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm good.
All right, so you actually know these people, or you just happen to see the apartment?
And the dog is always locked in the car.
Do they bring the dog in at night?
No.
The dog stays in the car? And the car has no plates on it?
No.
I mean, that's illegal, so we could just go that route if we can't reason with these people to just, you know, to just give up the dog. Whose dog is it, actually?
It's the parents, and then there's five kids.
There's five kids. All right. Kids or older kids?
No, 13 and under.
Oh, 13 and under. Okay, and the dog, you sure the dog sleeps in the car?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we're on our way. All right, so it's me, my lady. We got Mean Leon Green. We got Tommy Graziano, a.k.a. Tommy Guns. And we just received a phone call about people who are living in Section 8, which is a special housing for people who get government assistance, that they have a dog that's living in a car, and the car has no license plates on it, so that's illegal. So we're gonna knock on the door. We're gonna first see if we can get them to give us the dog, and if they're not willing to give us the dog, then we'll just call the authorities and have the dog taken from them. So we're on our way right now, and hopefully we're coming back with a dog. All right? How's it going, my man? Yo, we're doing community outreach in the area, and we heard that you guys had a dog that you guys might need some help with that's living in a car.
Oh, yeah, I'm trying to get rid of him.
Yeah, let's go. We'll take him right
you
now.
You gonna take him?
Yeah.
What are you guys doing with him?
I'm a rescue, bro.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, all right, hold
on. I can actually let out. She's good. If you guys don't mind. All right.
Hey, baby. What are you doing? Huh? What are you doing? Okay.
Yeah. What do you, I mean, does
hold on,
do you
let me tell my wife.
Yeah,
look, she got shots, everything's up to date with her.
Good,
she's
good.
Let me tell my wife. She might.
He was saying his daughter is very sick. She got brain injury.
We'll make it to work.
Good. She was just saying,
yeah.
That's why I ended up at the hospital so much. That's why he's not able to take care of the
Okay,
she said. She's probably one of you. Yeah, right. She got a little hot spot on
her. Yeah.
Other than that, she's healthy.
Yeah.
Big girl. I mean, you're a big girl now.
Huh?
Look. Yes, you are.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know what's crazy? She looks like a puppy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, I saw the car come. I had to come over and say goodbye to my girl. I had to come over and say goodbye to my girl. Hi, my lovey. I wish I could take you so badly, Blue.
Oh, she's going to get a good home.
I wish I could take you so badly,
she'll
Blue.
She'll get a good home.
Oh, my baby girl. Oh, I'm so sorry.
How you doing?
I love you.
Yeah, I know. It sucks, but, you know, with the New York Bully Crew. I don't know if you heard of us, but we're a rescue.
You can follow
No, come in.
She's gonna go. Everything.
So she's not going to a permanent place right now?
No, she's going right now. Yeah. She's gonna go to our rescue. We have a 6,000 square foot facility.
I don't want her at a rescue.
No. It's an office. It's not like a rescue.
It's not a pound.
It's not a shelter. She's gonna be in a room. She's gonna be in a room on a dog bed right now. Yep. I'll send you pictures in a little bit.
Let her go for a second. Well, come here. True.
I hope you don't mind, Janeiro. I saw the card. What is going on?
Come here, girl.
Janet, did you guys say bye-bye?
Come here.
Such a good dog. No idea. What a great dog.
She could probably get adopted right away.
I would take her in a minute, but I have dogs at my house. I have very good experience.
I love you. She's not gonna come back.
The kids can come visit her. She's going to a new home.
Okay.
So she doesn't have to live in the car.
This is what's going on. Okay.
And then we'd like to make a donation to your daughter. You have a son or a daughter that's in the hospital?
Yeah.
Yeah, we want to make a donation.
So what you're doing is Blue is going to go to a home. You want to stop up at the rescue, maybe?
Yeah.
It's in East Patchogue, right on Montauk Highway, right on the crust of Belport.
All
right. I'll give you the address, and if you can come up there, I'll write you. Give you a couple hundred dollars for her medical care just to help you out. Yeah. Okay. You got it, man. Yeah. No doubt. Yeah.
And that way, we'll make a $500 donation to the care of your baby, and hopefully everything will work out. I'm glad we came by. You know?
It's a good thing for
Blue.
Thanks. Yeah.
She's going to be, you know.
So just so you know, we're going to make a $500 donation for your daughter that's in the hospital. We're going to make a $500 donation. So if you guys want, tomorrow, come up to the rescue, and I'll give you a check, and you can see where she'll be on a nice bed on a hardwood floor at the rescue.
How long have you guys been?
Since 2010.
Yeah.
Grinding. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
It's hard because I love her.
I know, but you're doing the right thing. You know, it's not fair to her live in a car.
So I told her.
Yeah. I know, and this is good because everyone sees a dog in a car and they don't understand that there's things behind the story. You know, and that's why I'm glad that we came here, and I'm glad that you know that it's the right thing to do. You do. I know you're upset, and I know she's upset, but you can come visit her, sweetie. You can come visit her anytime you want. You can come visit. Don't you want her to get a good home and be happy? And you can come visit her anytime you want.
That's what just makes me love you guys even more. That you're so being such.
There's always an underlying reason why things, situations like this happen.
Oh, of course.
And that's why we never judge.
No, you can't.
And we don't come here with an attitude.
This dog wouldn't be like this.
No, well, we don't come here with an attitude either. We're coming here because we only care about the dogs.
Right.
And obviously, we care about the humans too. But it's important for us that the dogs, live the right way. And you guys got some stuff going on that is preventing you from doing such. And we're going to do the right thing. So she has my personal cell phone number. So you come up to the rescue. I'm going to cut you guys a check for $500 for your daughter's medical care, and I'm going to give the kids shirts and everything. And you guys too. Okay?
All right,
you got it, my man. All right. You got it.
All right. Thank you.
And give me five. Look at this. You got your little computer over there? All right. Come on, bub. Come on. Come on. Come on. Good girl. So we knocked on the door, they came down, and basically he said he's been looking for a home. They have a daughter that's in the hospital with some medical issues, and so they gave up the dog. We're also going to make a nice $500 donation for their daughter's medical care. So once again, sometimes you just have to ask.
Yeah, you know you're going somewhere good, right?
Hello.
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 can do about
stuff.
Yeah, a little flakes.
Blue here, just picked her from Bay Shore. She had a little rash on her butt, and Doc said she just needs a nice clean bath and some Benadryl, and she'll be okay. And if she's not eating, we gotta bring her back in a week.
There you go.
Got it. Come on, girl. Good. Here.
Okay, so we'd like to educate some people on some safety tips on bringing up either a puppy or a dog. And the first thing we're going to go over are rope toys. Rope toys are very dangerous. They're dangerous because once the dog chews it and breaks it apart and swallows it, it could get caught in their intestines. So rope toys are okay if you're supervised with your pet, but never, ever leave a dog alone with rope toys, because the end result will be it'll destroy the rope eventually. After they destroy it and chew it and it's in their intestines, not even surgery will help. The second thing we'd like to go over with rope toys is the shaking of the head left to right. I know a lot of people like to play tug of war. Tug of war is okay back and forth, but left to right is how these scumbag dog fighters train dogs to fight, by shaking their head left to right. So tug of war is okay if you want to go forward to backwards, but shaking the head left to right is not okay. It is how they train dogs to fight. So keep that in mind when you're using a rope toy and playing tug of war. The next thing I would like to go over is rawhide. First and foremost, rawhide cannot be digested and is dangerous for any dog to swallow. That's number one. Number two is rawhide gets a dog to be possessive over the rawhide. I've seen good dogs become bone possessive over rawhide. I'm not exactly positive why that is, but I've seen it so many times and I've heard so many stories about dogs that were good dogs and could play with any bone or play with any toy or play with anything. And then once rawhide is introduced into the situation, the dog becomes possessive over it and aggressive. So please, it's dangerous to swallow. It's dangerous because they become possessive over it, and rawhide in general is absolutely no good.
This is Brooklyn. She's from Puerto Rico. She was recently brought up to us, the New York Bully Crew, and Jay and I are her foster family. She is a really great dog. She's got a lot of health problems, obviously, so we've been slowly introducing her to our pack. She has, as you can see, her ears were improperly cropped. She has a bunch of scar tissue. They said possibly, which it's not a definite because we haven't gone through that cancerous tissue in there as well. So they want to remove both ear canals to alleviate the constant infection and the pain, obviously, that she's in constantly. But in the process of doing blood work to get over to the specialist, they found that she was also heartworm positive and also has two tick-borne viruses that have to be treated with antibiotics. So those are being done now, which is doxycycline for 30 days. She has a 30-day rest period, and then after that, she will start her heartworm treatment. I believe it's one, and then she has a rest period and then another two where she stays at the vet all day so they can observe her. Once she's cleared from that, she'll have her ear surgery from the specialist. And she also has mammary tumors as well that have to be removed, so those will get done after everything is all said and done with her ears. But she's a really good girl, very sweet. We think she'd do great in another home with another dog if introduced properly, obviously, because she will be deaf after her surgery. So family's gonna have to be willing to work with her, but she's such a doll and eager to please and just an all-around great girl. You really couldn't ask for better. She's a doll face. Say what? What? Say it. Say it. Now you're not gonna do it? Good girl.
We're here with Aaron. He was found running around Melville with an infected wound on his neck chest area. We got that cleaned up for him and continue to monitor and clean the area. He was still not eating and was also throwing up digested blood. Between bringing him to Grady and the emergency vet, we ended up spending about $4,500 in vet bills. They did an aspirate of his stomach and intestines and discovered that he does have a thickening of the intestinal wall and the stomach wall, which is consistent with intestinal and stomach cancer. Since being released, he's been eating well and he's been taking his medication daily, and he's been much less lethargic. He's been doing much better since receiving the proper medical attention. Thank you all for your support towards us and towards Aaron.
Stay. Good boy, stay. Stay. Come! Thank you.